And today we're going to be talking about something called an EPROM, or an Erasable Programmable Read-Only Memory. I find it very interesting, and we're going to learn about how it was used in vintage computers, and how it's programmed, and kind of how the physics behind the transistor inside it works. Let's get started.
Danner, tech, Danner, tech, Danner, Danner, tech, Danner, tech, Danner. Hello, this is Danner Tech.
Alright, so this is the chip itself. It is called an EPROM. Now, you can typically distinguish an EPROM from any other kind of computer chip by these clear quartz windows on the top of each chip. And I'll explain a little bit about what these little windows do. But these chips were readily used in a lot of vintage computers because of their ability to hold data in a read-only format and also be reprogrammed when needed. Now, a friend gave me this specific circuit board out of a pile of old avionics equipment that his dad had given him. Now, this was taken from a pile that had all kinds of old airplane computers, probably autopilot and stuff, so this circuit board could very well have an autopilot program on it that helps control an airplane when it is flying, which is pretty cool to think about. I kind of want to explain to you a little bit about how this device works and how everything is stored on here. So typically, in an SD card like this one, you plug it into your computer and memory is stored on there. Now this is an 8 GB card, which is 8 million megabytes, which is pretty cool. This memory card is pretty big, but the interesting thing is you can plug into your computer and you can write programs to it, and you can erase programs to it actually very easily. This is called rewritable memory. But this is called ROM, or read-only memory, which means you can't actually write memory to it. The other interesting thing about this chip is because of its clear glass windows, the only way to erase this chip is by exposing it to an extremely high brightness UV light for approximately 10 minutes, which is pretty cool because you can't just erase this. You have to actually shine a light on this chip in order to erase it. So now let's look at how this works. So it uses something called an insulated gate transistor. So in a typical MOSFET, you have three pins. You have gate, drain, and source. Now when you have voltage on the gate, there's a little bit of a capacitance between the gate and the source. If you have a positive voltage on here, it puts in the positive electric charge between the gate and the source, and that allows current to flow between the drain and the source. But if you bring gate to ground and you discharge it, so there's no charge between gate and source, no current is able to flow. Now, you can't actually hold any memory with this because the charge would just bleed off eventually because of the capacitance. So what they do inside these chips, and the reason they have to be photo erased, is because they have something called insulated gate. This means that you have the same gate, drain, and source, but instead of having just one gate, you have two gates. But the second gate is actually physically insulated from all other parts of the chip by an oxide layer. Most chips need only a 5-volt logic level signal to be programmed in red, but these EEPROM chips need actually a very high voltage to be programmed. So what happens is when you erase it, you put the UV light on it, and what happens is the UV light will cause any charge on this floating gate to completely dissipate and go away, which means this will function like a normal transistor because if you add a small charge onto the gate, it'll cause a conduction between the drain and the source, and that will be registered as a 1. Because if you put a voltage on here, there'll be a conduction on here, so that will be a bit of 1. And so when you put UV lights on these entire chips, it causes the entire chip to be erased and all the bits to a state of 1. And that's a lot because in each one of these chips, according to the data sheet, there are 1 million bits, which means in this whole chip full of 8 different chips, and if each chip has a million, that's 8 million bits, which means 1 megabyte. So this is 1 megabyte and this is 8 gigabytes. It's crazy how much technology has evolved. Anyway, what happens is when you want to program these chips, you actually program them to the zero state. And you do that by putting a high voltage on here, opposite, and that high voltage actually causes some electrons to go into this insulating layer. And once those electrons are in the insulating layer, then there is that layer that is insulated, and it's a negative charge. So what happens is when you want to put voltage on the gate, that voltage is going to be kind of blocked out by that negative charge, which means nothing's going to happen. So if you put a 1 on the gate in order to read it, it'll output a 0. Because what happens is, with these different transistors, you want to be able to add a voltage when you want to read them. So you don't just always have the transistor in the on or off state, you want to be able to read it. And so, let's say you wanted to read it and it had one state, you would put a voltage on here to read what the output would be, and if there were a lot of electrons right here and you put a read 1, you'd get an output of 0, but if there were no electrons here and you put a read 1, you'd get an output of 1. And so you have to program these with a typical high voltage. Usually this high voltage goes anywhere between 12 and 25 volts. And you use that once to program it, and once it's all programmed, and all the transistors that you want are 0, then you can use it to read, and you just cover up these chips, and the EPROM will be useful for many more years. So let's say you had your completely erased EPROM chip, and all the bits were set to 1. You'd plug it into your computer, which would have an EPROM programmer, and it would use some serial data connection to set whatever bytes it needs to 0. And so a programmed one would be 10011000011. So it would look something like that. And you would leave all the bytes 1 that you didn't want to change. But what happens is after you program it, you can't unprogram it because all the bytes that are set to 0 can't be changed back to 1 because there's a charge here without applying UV light, because the UV light would help dissipate the charge. So that's pretty cool. You have to use a UV light to reset all your chips. Let's take a closer look at one of these chips. Here's a cool look at one of these chips up close. So I've got my camera set to really see them up close. As you can see, these chips were actually created in 1986, which is a long time ago. You can see through that little quartz window, which it has to be quartz, by the way, in order for the UV light to pass through. You can see how rainbow and shiny it is, because that's all the different transistors on that tiny chip. Now, if you think about it, there's over a million transistors on that one tiny chip. There's a lot more transistors on newer chips nowadays, but still, that looks pretty cool. You can see even all the little wires connecting the little chip. Now, the interesting thing about these chips is that they have to be erased using a special kind of ultraviolet light. Because, of course, you have the ultraviolet light from the sun, and of course you have the light from these fluorescent light tubes. But only one type of fluorescent light works, and that is pure fluorescent light from mercury vapor light bulb, such as a germicidal light bulb. Now, in typical fluorescent light tubes, you have mercury vapor inside here. But there's this coating of phosphor on the outside, and that coating of phosphor blocks out all of the ultraviolet light that's coming out of that tube, and it converts it to light. So inside these EPROM chips, they need pure ultraviolet light to dissipate all the charge stored in those transistors. And so you need a germicidal light. So let's say if you wanted to put a germicidal light directly onto these chips, it would take approximately 20 minutes to fully erase all of the chips. If you put it under a fluorescent light, it would take a few months to erase everything. If you put it under the light of the sun directly, it would take about a week to erase all of the data on the chip. Now, this chip has probably been sitting in my room for quite a long time, so there's a good chance that it's been erased since 1986 when it was designed, and probably programmed at first for the aviation industry. But anyway, I just thought that was something cool to share with you guys, how these EEPROM chips work and how they are able to store some data. It's kind of cool to look at these old chips because they were widely used in the 80s, 90s, and they stopped using them in the 2000s, but it's still kind of cool to see them and see how they work. Because they were a massive revolution in terms of computing. Because before you just had read-only memory, which could only be programmed one time. And after that one time you couldn't reprogram it, you'd have to buy a new chip. But these opened a new realm of possibilities, because you could reprogram your computer. You could reprogram the read-only memory. Nowadays, we have EEPROMs, and EEPROMs are electrically erasable, programmable read-only memory, which means instead of using some annoying UV light, you can erase them programmably. And this EEPROM is what makes flashcards work and the modern memory that we so much enjoy today. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for next time.